Good morning to Arnold Person here. Today in this session we are going to see about fit biasing. So in this fit biasing time, before going to see about the types of field effect transistor biasing, we have to see go and see the introduction, the general relationship that can be applied to the DC analysis of all FET amplifier or IG equal to 0 amps and ID equal to IS. And also we have to know about this Shockley's equation, that is, it is applied to relate the input and output quantities, that is ID equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS divided by VP the whole square. For enhancement type MOSFET, the following equation is also applicable, that is ID equal to K into VGS minus VT the whole square. It is particularly important to realize that all of the equations above are for the devices only. They do not change with each network configuration as long as the device is in active region. And there are three types of biasing configuration. One is the fixed bias configuration, and the other one is the voltage to connected to base bias, and last one is the voltage divider biasing. Here first we have going to see the fixed bias configuration. Here in this fixed bias configuration, the diagram is shown. Here the V1 and V2 are the input and output AC levels, and C1 and C2 are the coupling capacitors. And for DC analysis, IG equal to 0 amps, and that is IG RG equal to 0 amps or RG equal to 0. The 0 volt drop across RG permits replacing RG by a short circuit equivalent as appearing in the network for the DC analysis. The fact that the negative terminal of a battery is connected directly to the defined positive potential of VGS clearly reveals that the polarity of VGS is directly opposite to that of the VGG. By applying Kirchhoff's voltage law in the clockwise direction, that is minus VGG minus VGS is equal to 0 and VGS is equal to minus VGG. Since VGG is a fixed DC supply, the voltage VGS is fixed in magnitude, resulting in the notation fixed bias configuration. The resulting level of drain current, that is ID, is now controlled by Shockley's equation, that is ID equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS divided by VP the whole square. Since VGS is a fixed quantity, its magnitude and sign can simply be substituted into Shockley's equation and the resulting level of ID calculated. Here a mathematical solution to the FET configuration is quite direct. Once the network is constructed and operating the DC levels of ID and VGS, that will be measured by the meters or the quotient point. The drain to source voltage VDS of the output section can be determined by applying the Kirchhoff's voltage law, that is plus VDS plus IDRD minus VDD equal to 0, or VDS is equal to VDD minus IDRD. And as we already know, the single subscript voltage refers to the voltage at a point with respect to ground, that is VS is equal to 0. So here that will be the fixed bias configuration, and these are all the problems that is related to the fixed bias configuration. And after that fixed bias configuration, we are going to see about the cell bias configuration. The cell bias configuration eliminates the need for two DC supplies as required for fixed bias configuration. The controlling gate to source voltage, that is VGS, is now determined by the voltage across the resistor RS introduced in the source leg of the configuration. The figure shows the cell bias configuration, and the other one shows the without capacitance. The current RS is a source element IS, but IS is equal to ID, and VR equal to ID into RS. For indicated loop, we find that minus VGS minus VRF is equal to 0, or VGS is equal to minus VR into F, or it can be written as ID into RS. So VGS is equal to minus ID into RS. Note that VGS is a function of the output current ID and not fixed in magnitude as occurred for the fixed bias configuration. The mathematical solution could be obtained simply by substituting the above equation into Shockley's equation as shown below. that is ID equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS divided by VP the whole square. And also we know that the value for VGS, that is minus ID into RS, so that will be equal to IDSS into 1 minus ID into RS divided by VP, or it can be written as ID equal to IDSS into 1 plus IDS ID into RS divided by VP the whole square. First, the transfer characteristics are defined by using the 3 point, and then the straight line is drawn, that is has to be defined as the shame graph by identifying 2 points. In the figure shows the example for cell BIOS configuration in this slide, and these are all the 2 examples of cell BIOS configuration. And next one is the voltage divider BIOS. The voltage divider BIOS arrangements applied to BJT amplifier is also applied to FET amplifiers. The basic construction is exactly the same, but the DC analysis of each is quite different. That is, IG equal to 0 amps for FET amplifier, but the magnitude of IB for common emitter BJT amplifier can affect the DC levels of both current as well as voltage in input and output circuit. Recall that IB provided the link between input and output circuit for BJT voltage divider configuration, while IGS, that is VGS, will do the same for the FET configuration. The network can be redrawn as you shown in the next slide for the DC analysis. Note that all the capacitors, including the bypass capacitor, have been replaced by open circuit equivalent. In addition, the source VDD was separated into 2 equivalent sources to permit a further separation of input and output regions of the network. And also we are applying Kirchhoff's current law requirements that IR equal to IR2, and the series equivalent circuit appearing to the left of the figure can be used to find the level of VG. The voltage VG equal to the voltage across R2 can be found using the voltage divider rule as follows. That is, VG equal to R2 into VDD divided by R1 plus R2. KVL is the clockwise direction to the indicated loop, which will result in VG minus VGS minus VRF is equal to 0, or VGS is equal to VG minus VRF. And as we already know, by substituting the value for VR of, that is IS into RS is equal to ID into RS, we have, that is, VGS is equal to VG minus ID into RS. The procedure for plotting the above equation is not a difficult one, and it will proceed in the next slide. So the figure, since any straight line requires 2 points to be defined, first we can use the fact that anywhere on the horizontal axis, the current ID is equal to 0 milliamps. Therefore, select ID to be 0 milliamps. We are stating that we are somewhere on the horizontal axis. The exact location can be determined by substituting ID equal to 0 milliamps into the previous equation and finding the resulting value of VGS as follows. VGS is equal to VG minus ID into RS, or it will be ID equal to 0, so it will be VGS is equal to VG. So this is for point number 1, and for point number 2, ID equal to VG divided by RS, and this is the point number 2. And also it is obvious that we can able to find out the equation both for MOSFET also. Here in this type, that is a depletion type MOSFET, the similarities in appearance, that is between the transfer curve of JFET and the depletion type MOSFET, permits a similar analysis of each in the DC domain. The primary difference between the two is the fact that depletion type MOSFET permits the operating point with positive values of VGS and levels of ID that exist IDSS. In fact, for all the configuration discussed, the analysis is the same if the JFET is replaced by the depletion type MOSFET. And then the figure shows the example for the MOSFET, depletion type MOSFET, and it is for the enhancement type The transfer characteristics of enhancement type MOSFET are quite different from those encountered for the JFET, and depletion type MOSFET resulting in a graphical solution quite different for the preceding sections. Recall that for n-channel enhancement type, the drain current is zero for levels of gate to source voltage. VG is less than the threshold volt. For levels of VGS greater than VGS threshold, the drain current is defined as ID equal to K into VGS minus VGS threshold whole square. And also we have to find out the value for K, that is K is equal to ID divided by VGS, ID on divided by VGS on minus VGS threshold. Once K is defined, the other levels of ID can be determined for chosen values of VGS. Typically, a point between VGS threshold and VGS on at 1 just greater than VGS on will provide a sufficient number of points for the plotting. And these are all the enhancement and depletion type model examples. And the last one is the voltage divided bias arrangements. And the second popular arrangement for enhancement type MOSFET is the voltage divider bias arrangement. The fact that IG equal to 0 amps, and by using the voltage divider rule, that is VG equal to R2 VDD divided by R1 plus R2, by applying Kirchhoff's around the indicated loop, that will be plus VGG minus VGS minus VRF is equal to 0, and VGS is equal to VG minus ID into RS. And for the output section, it will be VDS is equal to VDD minus ID into RS plus RD. Once we have find out the value of IDQ and VGSQ are known, all the remaining quantities such as VDS, VD and VS can be determined. And the figure shows the example for that. Thank you.